The new stepper motor drive from Automation Direct has all the great features you're used to with the open frame stepper drives, but the new drive also has the following. It's fully enclosed to protect the electronics. All switch settings and diagnostics are printed right on the cover for quick and easy reference. It has double the current range so you can handle larger motors. It has double the voltage range so you can work with more standard voltages. It has double the step resolution for more accuracy and speed. And while both have step and direction, the new drive also has clockwise, counterclockwise mode too. It has an output signal so the PLC can actually monitor the status of your drive. It has a switch selectable inertia setting so you can optimize the performance for both low and high loads. It has a noise filter to help ensure accurate stepping even at the high pulse rates. And while this drive will work with any compatible stepper motor, it's optimized for the steppers offered by Automation Direct for the absolute best performance. In full step mode, while the stepping is usually very coarse, there's a switch selectable step smoothing option which approximates microstepping so you get the best of both worlds, smooth operation at both high and low speeds. This unit has removable plugs. Now you can swap out drives without having to rewire. Just unplug the drive and plug a new one in. You're done. And finally, this unit has dedicated status, error, and fault code LEDs. And the best news is, you get all of these added features for just $89. That's right, a much better drive for a fraction of the price. And setting it up couldn't be easier. I have a 23079 stepper motor from Automation Direct, so we look at the drive cover, and we see we need to dial in an A on the rotary switch. Remember, while this drive will work with any general stepper with similar specs, it's optimized for, and you'll get the best performance if you use the Automation Direct steppers. On our dip switches, we can choose current reduction. We'll use the 120% for this demo since we're going to be using microstepping. You can select the load inertia. We have a light to medium load, so we'll choose that one. And we'll choose the 50% idle current reduction for our example. Our stepper resolution will be 20,000 steps per revolution. And let's enable self-test for our initial testing. Now we just wire it up. Our example is wired like this. We have a Do More PLC controlling the stepper from a C3O module. We have a 4805 power supply providing the power for the module. And we're using a 23079 motor with this convenient extension cable to connect right to the stepper drive. That's it, that's our entire setup. Since we have the unit in self-test mode, we just turn it on. We expect to see the motor turn twice in one direction and then twice in the other. Perfect, exactly what we expect. The beauty of this self-test is it guarantees the motor's wired correctly and the voltages are correct, independent of the input wiring. In fact, the input wiring doesn't even have to be connected for self-test to work. That's a really handy feature. Now we just flip the self-test switch back to the normal position. It is okay to do that while the unit's powered up. We have an Automation Direct Do More PLC setup to drive this stepper with a simple dynamic velocity instruction. This allows me to change the rate to anything I want while the stepper's running. We're currently set up for microstepping right now at 20,000 pulses per shaft revolution. So if we hit it with 40,000 pulses, then we should see 2 revolutions per second, right? I'm going to enable this instruction by flipping the PLC's X7 input. And sure enough, the motor ramps up and we get our 2 revolutions per second. If we change SP to 10,000 pulses, then the motor ramps down to 1/2 revolution per second. Perfect. Let's look at the pulse smoothing options when using full step mode. To do that, we go back and change the dip switch settings to give us 200 pulses per revolution, or dip switches 5, 6, and 7 set all to on. And let's send it, how about 20 pulses per second, something slow, so we can see the stepping. I'm going to reach down and enable our instruction. And I don't know if you can see it in the video or not, but you certainly can hear the stepper pounding against my desk as it makes each individual step. I'm going to turn that off, it's annoying. This time I'm going to turn it on, then I'm going to reach down to the motor drive, and I'm going to switch dip switch 5 to off. That'll put us in smoothing mode, and you'll immediately hear the difference. Here we go. Now the motor's still turning, but all that coarseness is gone. Now it's very smooth. This isn't true microstepping, it's an approximation, but it's pretty close. That's an awesome feature because now you have fast stepping and smooth operation. One more thing, let's introduce an error. Let's power down, disconnect the motor winding, and power back up. By the way, you should never disconnect a motor lead while the system's powered up. Look, the error code is being flashed on the LED. I see 1 green and 6 red flashes. On my drive housing, I see that corresponds to an open motor winding. I love being able to do that without having to go find the manual. Note that you need to power cycle the unit to reset the error codes. A couple notes. This unit has a slightly different form factor than that open frame 4035 drive, so don't assume it's a drop-in replacement. The new one's about the same width, but it's also a little shorter and a little longer. If you need to change the input signal type from step and direction to clockwise counterclockwise, just open it up and move these jumpers. This one is set up for step and direction with extra noise filtering turned on, as shown in this chart. Well, that ought to be enough to get you up and running. Please let us know if we can be of any assistance. Automation Direct's tech support is always free and available for you via phone, email, or of course the absolute best place to start is right here online, where you'll find a wealth of information in the form of FAQs, support documentation, examples, tutorials, you name it, it's probably there. Automation Direct, your price, performance, and tech support leader.